I get second place, I will not be sad. I will be happy that I've earned $100,000 and had a great time here and played a game that I'm proud of the way I played it. But I want the million. I really want the million. Oh, my God, it would change my life.
What it boils down to is, did I come here for 42 days to starve, to live in the type of environment that I've lived in, to make those type of sacrifices, to give somebody like Elizabeth $1 million? Or did I come here to play this game and me deserve $1 million?
Tonight at Tribal Council, you know, I think it's gonna be a one vote jury. I see myself getting the guy votes, Lex and Tom and Frank. And I see Kim getting the girl votes, which is Kelly, little Kim and Teresa. And Brandon is gonna be maybe the swing vote.
I hope that the jury will look at the way I played this game as very strategic, extremely decisive, in some parts deceiving, but when you look at some of the deceptive parts, they have put me in line to get to where I am, and it was a great strategy.
This is strictly a game to me. It was about building relationships and cutting your losses to move on to the next level, to get to a certain position. But the relationships that you built weren't necessarily real. It's a sad fact of reality that this game is a little brutal. This game is dangerous. If you don't have strong skin, you're gonna be done quick. Just over the last couple days, things have gotten pretty touch and go, and there might have been some opinions formed in how cutthroat I am. It's a little scary to be sitting up there with the spotlight on you, interrogated.
It's over. It's out of our hands. We have done all we can do. The jury will come back tonight with questions. That's kind of like our last chance to really cement what we feel about ourselves and them one last time to the jury. I do feel like the majority of the jury probably already has their decision made by the time they came there. I would, you know, but it's out of our hands, really out of our hands right now.
To this day, no one has ever put my name on a piece of parchment. They write it tonight to give me the money. It'll be for a good reason, not for a bad reason. And that was one of my goals. Zoe's a good person. So I don't know why she doesn't deserve it more than I do, or why she does deserve it more than I do. I hope I win $1 million tonight. I think I have a good chance.
And it matches with your uniform.
I think that what this will come down to is a 3-4 vote. It's gonna be something real close.
The way the day is ending with this rain and being miserable is of course bringing on the miserable feelings of going to Tribal Council. I think the vibe of the jury tonight is gonna be pretty cold. You know, they came out here with their second chance, and the fact that they didn't get to finish it and we did, I don't think they're gonna make this easy for us at all. I think the jury would love to see Rob and I squirm.
It's kind of ironic, you know, at the Alente camp when there was 6 women and just me. I wasn't in charge. I wasn't the chief. I wasn't making the calls. And that's the opposite of what this place is all about. You know, that's their heritage. That's what they believe in. And now it's down to me and a woman. If unfortunately I get second place, being the last man in the game, that's an accomplishment in itself. I never dreamed I'd be where I'm at. No way. And it's still hard, you know? It doesn't quit. I guess it'll quit when I walk off this island and it's completely over.
The jury tonight, no treachery or half-truths or sugarcoating things. Whatever I did got me to where I am right now, and so be it. Now it's in their hands, not mine.
No matter what situation in life you're in, you may be down, but you're never out. That is a huge lesson that I've learned to hear. For the jury tonight, I plan on just being myself. I try to be a nice person, the girl, all-American girl next door. So it just kind of depends on the questions they ask and then how, you know, I need to react to it.
This has been an amazing ride, and hopefully there will be an amazing reward at the end of it. But I'm just so grateful that I got the time out here that I got. I'll never forget the moments that I spent out here and the people that I spent the moments with.
The fact that I was able to start this whole adventure with Becky on day one, the fact that I'm able to finish it with her, you know, it's gotta be a dream, right?
Oh, congratulations, guys!
Yeah. Finding a really good friend is worth more than $1 million. I mean, friendships like the one that I have with Becky, I think, are that rare.
What is that?
Fruit?
Good.
I tried to play the game with as much integrity as I could. I know that I failed in a lot of respects, but, you know, hopefully people won't hold it against me that I beat them.
I'm pretty proud of myself for making it this far. This is one of the highest peaks of my life because I've challenged myself so much in this game, and I made it all the way through just as planned. I mean, it's a cool experience. You won't know until you do it, till you give up everything in your lifestyle and come here and get in the dirt, in the mud, in the grind, and make it happen. Still be yourself, be strong. See what you're made of. See if you're really a man or a woman. The experience of a lifetime.
I feel like looking at the jury, I stand an okay shot. I backstabbed and lied to a lot of them, but I was playing a game. And whether I win $1 million tonight or not, I feel like I've accomplished a lot, and I'm so proud.
My game was a lot more aggressive than Amanda's game. It was a lot more cutthroat, more cold-blooded. I was playing it to win.
We're pyromaniacs.
That's awesome.
I think my strongest point that I can make tonight is standing up and owning that I have been a powerful, controlling player throughout the duration of this game.
I'm building my last final gadget, and that is a fiery goodbye to the Garden of Eden.
This is why my mother wouldn't let me play with matches.
You're a bit of a pyro yourself, weren't you?
Oh, yeah.
We just packed the inside of the hut with pieces of the other hut so that we can torch it and say goodbye to No Bag Camp in a blaze of glory. Okay, Susie, let's go. Time to say goodnight. I've still got one more major thing to do in Gabal, and that is convince the jury that my behavior, my work, my participation in this game is worth winning $1 million over Susie and over Sugar.
Steve and myself, we are the last two standing. Going into the tribal council tonight, there's no doubt about it, I'm gonna have to lay all of our friendship stuff aside because whatever it takes to win $1 million, now I gotta do it. You know, I brought along competition. That's what I wanted, and I got it. But, man, I've never had any doubts in tribal council till tonight.
I think there may be a little bit of strategy involved to wrestle, making us feel like we're not going to win or that we don't have a chance. But I have news for him. I'm not going to give up. And I'll just explain to the jury, I don't work the same way as wrestle. That would clearly not have worked for me. The girls that were aggressive, they got eliminated early. My strategy was to be myself. And at the end of the day, you know, I wasn't out to get anybody or make anybody look bad. Russell made it clear he was okay with making people look bad.
I don't think it's about the money tonight. I think it's about the title of sole survivor. That's all Russell wants. And if that's what Russell wants, that's what I got to make sure Russell does not get.
I don't get my hat. I ain't leaving.
Well, we're going to have to leave.
I don't give a.
There's not a day that didn't go by that I was trying to focus on what's the best way for me to get rid of Russell.
Okay.
And the worst thing of all is that those heroes, each and every one of them are responsible for their own self-destruction.
Woo!
When I was out here, I had to hustle. I had to make sure all my stuff was in order so that when I went to tribal council, I made it out in one piece. I didn't hide behind no immunity necklace. I never had safety. I had to take care of myself.
Woo! Look at it go wild.
And yet here I sit, final three. I think I deserve it. I want the title of sole survivor.
It's time to shift gears and focus on tonight's tribal council because if you're not completely in it to win it tonight, you're gonna miss your chance at $1 million, and those are the largest stakes I've ever played for. So I'm gonna go into this last tribal council swinging.
I haven't stopped playing the game. To some people, it may look like I'm giving pointers to Natalie, but I'm actually giving Natalie pointers on how I want her to handle tribal council. And twice, you know, I made it all the way to the end. The first time the jury didn't feel I was worthy. I'm hoping that tonight I'm not gonna screw it up again. As far as I'm concerned, I've done my job.
I talked to Coach a bit about how to handle Albert. I'd like Albert to live up in tribal council to being a bit squirrely, a bit wormy.
I truly don't have anything bad to say about you, and I'm not going to. I mean, there's nothing really for me to say about you.
I've thought today more and more about my emotional breakdown at tribal. I want to keep my composure tonight. The last thing I want to do is seem like this complete, you know, nut job, you know, crazy emotional crying because I think that's somebody who doesn't deserve to go to the end. So I'm going to try to go in perhaps a bit more logically than emotionally.
This year has been kind of a tough year for me. I just recently got divorced, and you know, coming out of a really tough marriage after almost 4 years, you look back and you're like, man, I got married to this person, and wow, it really doesn't work. It sort of shakes something in you. So coming out here and having to make decisions quickly day in and day out and have them work and get to sit here at the end and say, wow, those decisions worked out and it went really well, I've definitely gained some of my confidence back and trusting myself, trusting my discernment, my intuition, and there hasn't been a wrong turn. I'm excited to take this and take it back to my real life.
It was great to hike up to the cliff this morning, you know, to have the three of us and just to sit up here and have a different perspective.
Who knew that in 39 days, such significant life change could happen, such deep connections could be built?
Here I am, this little old sex therapist from Cedar Rapids, Iowa, that everybody thinks is probably going to float on coattails, who actually has played some strategy. And I feel like I'm thriving out here.
The first time in 39 days I've really felt frazzled is today. I've written a prize-winning paper at Harvard Law School on the survivor jury system. There's a big difference between writing a paper and living out the reality, and I'm grappling with that dichotomy right now. Law school hasn't prepared me for this. You'd think it would. Sorry, Harvard, you haven't really taught me that much about how to address a jury. But I'm going to learn my lesson tonight, I think. Whenever things are looking good for me, I suddenly start expecting the worst and preparing myself for the worst. Am I going to be able to get onto Survivor, which I've been dreaming of doing for half my life? No, I'm a loser. They're never going to want somebody like me. And I get on, and I get to return as a favorite. And you know, this endgame scenario is no different. I feel like I've played a great game. I've gotten to the end. This is my game to lose. But all of a sudden, these doubts are plaguing my mind. I'm just kind of this awkward geek who hasn't really done anything. I know I've done stuff, and I know I can express myself, but this doubt just creeps in or seeps in. And it's not healthy, especially when I have to be pleading my case and showing that I'm confident in the game I've played. But when I'm not feeling confident in myself, it's hard to do.